All right, everyone. So this is kind of a new idea that I have for the channel where for now it's mostly just gonna be albums for artists that I'm super excited for that have been with me for a long time. Just kind of my most anticipated albums of the year. But Kid Cudi just released Man on the Moon 3, and every single one of Kid Cudi's albums, but especially Man on the Moon 1 and 2, got me through a lot of my life and have so much respect for him as an artist, as a person, for those albums. I listen to them daily. I've been listening to them daily for the past 10 years, and truly, he's been with me for a long, long time. His music has just absolutely moved me. It's done incredible things for me. Just help make me the person I am today. So, we are going to do an album reaction. I don't know enough about music to really do a album review for this. I'm just gonna jam along to it, say what I like, what I don't like about it. First impressions of the album basically is what this is gonna be. So, without further ado, so first song is A Beautiful Trip. Let us get into it. Just about 37 seconds long. Can you hear that? It's got Miss Cudi versus the world. Right into song number two, Tequila Shots.
As he falls back deeper into a state. The return. As my mind is speeding by, I won't know. Asking God to help him when you hit me. Girl is telling me she don't know what she want. Lot of demons creeping up the living underneath. Gotta take a minute, y'all travel far. Feeling something, though I can't ignore my instincts. Back just where I started.
I love that instrumental. That personal conflict. I was really hoping to hear a bunch of old callbacks.
I'll give him the satisfaction.
So, track number four, she knows this. Ooh. Love that growl bass in the background. See the influence of like the Travis Scott type of you see the influence of the Travis Scott vocals and his production style, mostly in this song, but in the album so much. Yeah, he is. Yeah, there you go. I remember him saying he loves the party around Travis Scott, so definitely hear it on this track.
She knows this.
My goodness. Yes, Cudi. We're gonna transfer on to track number five, which is entitled Dive. So hit me with something, Cudder.
Seen the night that shorty with the fat fat moving to the vibes. Sound this up in my habitat, play a little bit of tech, keep home and drive, fried. I'm saying it's no saying goodbye.
Love it. Song number six, this is Damaged.
Don't tell the boys we get ripped. Rage on. It's the cops, what problem? Hanging all of my whip. Yeehaw. It's the bomb of my fam. This is all about fixing face. Long. Can't stop us for no. Nah. King was in the you ain't here. Yeah.
We off, we slide, we ain't scared to die. Speedless, more sex.
That's slick as hell.
Yeah, I figured that I'm empty, but I'm on a ride. Take it slow, well, no aiming for.
Oh, track number 7. This is called Heaven on Earth.
From the dawn. Yeah. Heaven on Earth, I am curious. Yeah, I'm living.
Transferring into song number 8, just about halfway through the album now. This is Show Out with Skepta and Pop Smoke. So excited for this one.
Look.
Yeah, Pop.
Show up. Back out. Pull up.
Yo, and rest in peace, Pop Smoke, man. He was gonna be a legend. He was, or he already is now. Fuck yeah, Skepta.
Back on tour with the gang and it's sold out. 22 dates, I ain't missing a show. Got the ladies hitting my phone. Got the man them hitting the wall. Me plus 10 on the list, they know how I'm coming. I'm bringing the bros, and I got G's. Show up, see it's full of
blood.
Back out, pull up.
Cudi harmonizing with Smoke sounds so good. I thought Quavo did an amazing job on Shoot for the Moon, but that was sounds so good.
Don't can't trip, get grip. Hands all over these chips. Watch this flip. No, see, I ain't no buying on bit. I pull it with chicks, the men in the mid. See, I'm not dwelling on that. Focus on running these last, believe.
Oh my goodness. Like, this is reminds me of Birds in the Trap type instrumentals that he's going off of, and he sounds absolutely perfect over top of all of them. Jeez. This has been hit for hit for hit. Yeah, Show Out is incredible. This is a stand up for me right now. And now, Mr. Soladolo Part 3. This should be a really good one. So that was a really personal song for Cudi. That was really good. But now we're on to track number 10. This is called Sad People. Oh. Those vocals are just what I need. Yeah, this album's starting to take a little bit more of a personal turn and just Cudi overcoming a lot, and I'm loving it. But now we have Elisa's baby boy. This is track number 11. This reminds me back of like Cudi's days with Wizard and doing all those old covers of Now we're transferring to song number 12, which is going to be September 16th. There's those famous hums. La 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 la. I could just hum anything and it's gonna be the most amazing thing in the world. It gives me life and happiness, and I don't know where I'd be without Kid Cudi hums in my life. Like, Kid Cudi hums to me is the equivalent of like when you're young and you won like some cool award in sports, your parents would go and take you to like McDonald's, or that feeling where your parents would take you out of school early and you would come like to go to the dentist or whatever, and you would come back with McDonald's and how cool you felt and how amazing you felt because you were the cool kid who got McDonald's where everyone else had to eat their crappy lunches. That's what Kid Cudi hums to me. That's how happy they make me feel. So now moving on to track number 13. This is The Void. That hit hard.
Fall in the void, just to avoid anything that can bring me down.
This is just going spiritual mode.
I promise you.
Oh my goodness. This album is really good. So now we have track number 14. This is Loving Me featuring Phoebe Bridgers. Let's see what they got for us.
I know he's all I got. Our best don't matter, babe. I'm much stronger and by much farther. So overseas, finally see. I'll keep on climbing. I told myself I cannot go.
The drums are so powerful.
Ooh. Never heard of your Phoebe Bridgers, but you're fucking killing this. Perfect. What a track. That was really good. And now we're on to song number 15. This is The Pale Moonlight.
I can see, Lord, I was born to be strong. Yes, yes, before I stress, I gotta get that feeling. This is just a sweet interlude. Amen. And then I just totally coming with it. What's this? Hey, got no time, my boy. No, man, no.
All right, third to last song. This is Rockstar Nights with Trippy Red. I'm actually kind of, I'm really curious about this song. I think it's probably gonna be hype.
Rockstar life, dim the lights, baby, I don't wanna do this.
I love that rockstar.
Yeah, to the end, in the end, I'm gonna be who I am. I ain't worried about work, goddamn. Build an empire in the city of the damn. In a building, see reclining, now I see who I am. See show what a bad, pretty feet of sand.
Trippy sounds so different on this, but sounds really good. I think this is easily like one of my favorite just anything from him. Fuck yes, Cudi. He sounds so good at instruments like this.
Tell him it's a sequel to all them days that I was faded, figured I was too. Seen the days in the same
Yeah, this was a stand-on song for me too. That was really good. And now, penultimate song, track number 17 for the kids. Ooh. Ooh. If this is just full of hums and vocalizations.
Song is dedicated.
Ooh.
Do it all day for the kiddies. Real life dreamers in the suburbs and the cities. Riding around town, windows up, steaming, beaming. Singing along to it in the cut, heavy streaming. Mama don't know what a little feeling. Daddy been gone, and my brother stay tripping. Family know, homie, that's lonely. This is all for you, people pick up on the phony. All in the plan. As you grow, make the moments last. You can't stop feeling.
Load right now, let's go.
Never lose hope if you don't keep it golden. Always keep your family close. This is just the right vibe.
Album's been the right vibe, man. This song gives me more of like the Passion, Pain, and Demon Slayer vibes. Oh. My goodness, it's going back to those little sounds and just background noises that he had in that album one. And just... Yes, you have. Yes, you have, Cudi. That was a standout, too. Now, Lord, I know this is the last track on the album.
Ooh.
That bass just came in hard.
Ain't the same way it was, like it's not the hit the button.
goodness. This whole album has just been... that had a lot of stress on my head and my chest. And just... man. How are you doing, man? To be continued. He's in the final installment, so does that mean Man on the Moon 4? Alright, so I'm actually not too certain what to expect with that to be continued at the end there, but I don't know if the story of this album is just going to continue in one of his albums like Intergalactic when he releases that, or the Scots, or all the music that he has going on. He has a lot coming out, which is going to be amazing. Kids He Goes To, all of that, but damn, what a powerful and beautiful album. If he does do Man on the Moon 4, I'm here for it, because this was easily my favorite album since he's put out since Man on the Moon 2. I loved Indie Cud. Satellite Flight was pretty good. Even Passion Pain and Demon's Land is something that I held very close to me. But since Man on the Moon 2, on his own, so this doesn't include Kids See Ghosts, what in... absolutely amazing, powerful, super well mixed, super well produced album. His content, his lyrics on everything was amazing. His flow, don't even get me started, absolutely amazing on the stellar production that he had. Every single feature was really good on this too. Skepta did his thing, Pop Smoke sounding like the legend he is, I'm gonna say. Not that he was gonna be, just an absolute legend. Phoebe Bridgers, never heard of her, but damn, you killed it. And Trippie Redd, I do have to say, favorite thing he's ever done. The features on this album was fantastic. And like, this is just my first reaction from it, but this was an album that like I've been waiting 10 years for, basically. Oh, just fantastic. And he really honed in on to just all the trauma, all the stress that he's been through, and how he's overcome it, and how powerful it is. And you can hear that in the drums in this album, his lyrics, his confidence, his everything with his delivery. Not just him projecting his voice, but just, like I said, the drums, the instrumentals, just how amazing everything felt. He has overcome so much, and he's just basically like in his prime right now, just being happy and loving the world and loving his fans, loving music, having fun creating and whatnot. And you could hear all of that in the messages of this album, just everything he was saying, and fantastic. It makes me so happy. Just to see him progress and do all these amazing things just makes me so happy, because like I said, he's gotten me through so much. Some very dark days where Cudi was the only light that I had, and this was many, many days. And this is an album that I really needed right at the moment. So, and I think a lot of us are going to need it, just with all the things we've been all going through and lots of stresses with internal, external things with ourselves. And Cudi just delivered right now what I know is going to be a classic for me and a masterpiece for me. I enjoyed every single minute of this album, just vibing along, listening to him, understanding more about him, more about myself, and just an absolutely amazing and beautiful album. Like I said, I'm not going to rate it, but easily like some of my favorite work he's ever put out. Standout songs for me have to be For the Kids, I Love She Knows This, Damage was really good, Show Out is fantastic, Loving Me is great. There's so many good songs on this album. The whole album is fantastic. What am I talking about? But yeah, absolutely unbelievable. But in the comments, please let me know, what was your favorite song off of Man on the Moon 3, and what are your thoughts about it? I, you know, that just spilled my guts out all over it, but I loved this album. And I can't wait to give it multiple more listens. But yeah, if you like me reacting to all this music, I'll try to do more of these. Like I said, for now, just time-wise and everything else I got going on, I might just do my favorite artists when they release their albums. And I definitely had to do one and start one out with Cudi. But you can check out all my other content that I do on this channel through my playlist down below. I am looking forward to doing more stuff like this, but of course give this video a thumbs up if you like it. And of course, if you like everything you see on my channel, you can subscribe and turn the little ringer on if you want to know when I upload new videos. And yeah, just awesome, guys. This was fantastic. And I can't wait for more Cudi really, really soon.